quite a few animals in this bit, didn't they, love?
No, you two llamas.
Do you want to give them something to eat?
I like brown bags. Oh, I'm too scared. I don't like llamas.
Don't you? Give me a couple, put on my hand, and I'll feed. What do you want me to feed, the llamas or the goats?
Oh,
that's enough. That's enough. Feed this one. Pretty cool, eh?
Feed the llama.
Want to feed the llama?
Feed the
llama. Okay. It's just little stacks. I want to see the turkey gobble again.
That's really scary, Daddy.
Yeah, honestly, the turkey gobble. Can a gobble for me? There you go.
I haven't seen these type of monkeys. There's one. That monkey's trying to find food.
Yeah.
Digging in a hole for food.
Yeah, they'll be getting the bugs out of the ground.
Right. Yeah. Do they eat bugs?
Yeah.
Yeah.
They eat they're like worms and stuff. All sorts of bugs. See, watch him. He's having a good dig in there, isn't he?
He keeps on looking up at you. Come on, swing over. Open your tail.
I'm video recording it so you can see it.
Ready.
Isn't it? None of them sheep type of sheep like that, don't they? Remember, he's got to last. Pretty cool, isn't it?
Daddy, there's one fake turtle.
Is there? He might be sleeping. Oh no, they're sleeping, love. Oh, these turtles are pretty cool. They're having
sleep. I think that one's a fake.
No, they're sunbathing.
Oh, that one. Yeah, that one's real.
Oh, he's having a good swim in there, isn't he?
What?
Having a good play in there, isn't he? They're real tiny little birds.
We used to scare the fish.
That's not nice. They're big koi fish, aren't they?
Yeah, we used to scare
them. Look, there's a little duck in here.
I'm gonna watch him tell that for you. You used to got help to hold the bird. Yeah, there's a white one over here.
Yeah, there's two. No, I'm trying to play in near the water.
I wonder if we can go this way.
He's having a drink, is he?
looking at his
Yeah, he's getting a bit of water in his hand, I think, having a drink. That's pretty out of it how the meerkats are in with the porcupine, isn't it?
Do you want to meet my friend? You sure? He's very nice.
I've seen most of the animals before.
Have you?
Touch him.
Have you touched some of the animals though?
I've touched that one.
You have? When
I
is
really
that?
Want to touch a meerkat.
I wouldn't advise that one. They've got very, very sharp teeth and very, very sharp claws. And it hurts a lot.
They look cute though.
They do look very cute, but unfortunately they're not as friendly as all that when you go in with them.
Hey, wait a second. Giant Liana and Walter came here.
There's a bait. There's them small ones.
It's big.
Is he? That's alright. Do you hear him squawk? There's another one in there. Don't worry about the duck. You look at the animals. That's all right. Do you know what type of monkey this is?
Is that a real bird?
Here it is, here. Don't kick the animals, please. The ducks are right. He just give him something to eat, love. It's all he wants. Yeah. Put your hand out and feed the pig. Put it on your hand and give it to him. They'll like it. They won't bite you. Yeah, put it in my hand and I'll do it. See? Yeah. See, look.
See,
slubber all over your hand. Pretty cool, though. Cool. Pretty
if he
cool.
If he's on the leaf, he'll turn green.
Really?
Yeah.
He's pretty old. You know, Tuataras are like as old as the dinosaurs.
I know, because they're type of dinosaurs.
Yeah, they're very old. Very nice, aren't they?
Tuataras are my favourite kind of animal. I'm allowed inside here.
So cool. Cool chinchilla. And what's up here? This never used to be like this. Have a look. Some turtles are over there, eh? Pretty warm in here.
What?
Pretty warm in here. I think they're over there sunbathing on that log, eh? Pretty cool. Porcupine, just throw them in here. That one's in there.
Hey, look,
actually would be in the same area, they'd just behaviourally be active at different times. Our meerkats are completely diurnal, so they'll come out during the day, whereas our porcupines are completely nocturnal, so they'll only ever come out at night, aside from here. That's just because they're pretty confident with coming out at the moment, just because they don't really have any threats. They're mostly going to be threatened by a couple of annoying meerkats. Usually they leave each other alone, except for when they kind of stir up and come out. They never come out during the day out in the wild, it's just far too risky for them. Yeah, this is about all the only threat they have. The other thing is stupid and decide to take them. Banana for a bit of a walk. They are completely carnivorous, meerkats, but that doesn't stop them from trying to get their banana.
Look at that one. Can I get a photo of them? Right, you're gonna have to. Hey,
Randy, right, I'm getting a porcupine.
Alright, let's get
something
that you
can
eat.
What if
you
touch the porcupine?
No, you don't
want
the sharp,
that's
what
you said. They should leave them alone from that. Alright, she's just being fussy now. But meanwhile, we've got a koto is coming over here now. Like I said, they're completely nocturnal. Aside from when there's food involved, generally they'll come out pretty quickly. And all these quills are just made out of pure keratin. So the same stuff here and nails are made out of. They've just adapted to be really long and really sharp. They'll use them as defense, obviously. They'll kind of use the actual sharp ones as like a last resort more than anything. First thing they'll do is make themselves look as big and scary as possible. All the quills will stand out on end, and they'll also start rattling their tail and things like that. You might be able to see that they've got these hollow quills on their tail. When they rattle them together, they sound a lot like a rattlesnake. And that's almost like a double bluff, just kind of as a bit of a warning off to say I'm not really what you think I am. And then they'll also stomp their feet and growl and things like that. And then as a last resort, then they'll reverse up and then back their quills in to whoever it is threatening them. They don't shoot out their quills. Their quills aren't poisonous or anything like that. But what they are just very dirty and very sharp. And they can actually move very, very quickly, despite the fact they're quite stumpy. But yeah. So most animals tend to stay clear of them, except for meerkats, obviously. Are a bit moody because they're too distracted to actually come over and ask for food. They're just going to demand it from them. But yeah, they mainly just eat insects and things like that out in the wild. In the wild, they'll be having things like scorpions typically, centipedes, millipedes, and things like that. Mm. Here we give them a lot of insects as well as day-old chicks, mice, and cat biscuits. Cat biscuits are really good because they're really high in taurine, so they get it for the exact same reason that domestic cats get them. So for taurine as well as dental hygiene as well, they're really good for cleaning teeth and things like that. Taurine just basically helps fight against enlarged hearts and things like that, which a lot of predatory animals will get if they don't have a lot of taurine in their diet, which would naturally occur in any live food that they eat. But yeah, and meanwhile our porcupines are completely herbivorous, so they'll only eat root vegetables and things like that. Yeah, hardy animal. Yeah, and these guys are actually the second largest rodent species in the world, but the largest porcupine species, and exceedingly friendly. Well, hungry. But yeah.
Right, yeah, well, thanks for that.
That's all right. My pleasure.
Get the spider.
Oh, can you get it?
Yuck.
Don't typically last very long once they've got them.
Oh.
Yeah, the worms we give them are usually things like locusts and waxworms, mealworms and crickets. It's the most common insects that we give them. Worms are, these earthworms are a bit of a special little treat. Oh, okay.
How come the porcupines don't spike you?
Oh, they're used to us coming in. They know we bring food. they tolerate us pretty well. Thank you.
horn in there. Another horn. Yes. You can just feed them all if I need you.
Hello, buddy.
Hello, the parrot.
Hey, you. Hello. Yeah. Hello.
Hello.
What you doing?
Long tail, hello.
Oh, really? You're a good talker.
Is it quiet?
Oh, you're a talker. Yeah. You're a pretty one, aren't you? What else you got to say, mate? Hey. He's shining, look at him. He looks cool. No, we're lucky it hasn't rained yet, aren't we? Where's the skinks? Can you see the skinks in here? Are they in here today?
Don't forget, but I can see one.
Where?
Ow! Thanks! Just joking. Hey, what's that crawling around? Dad?
Where?
Is that little tiny thing?
No, I can't see.
Crawling.
Oh.
Don't tell me.
Oh, there's a skink there.
I've moved containers.
Yeah. There is there. There's a lotus in here. Some fish. A koi. Look, the big fish at the back.
And
the lady's cleaning the tank.
Daddy.
Yeah?
Look,
what? Oh, there's a, Mexican walk, no, Mexican walking fish. Trying to think of the name, it starts with A.
And there's two of them.
Oh, there's two, there's a white one, two of them.
There's another one.
Oh, yeah.
So cool!
There's
so many
things! Yeah, there is.
And I put him back in. has got this.
Oh, yeah. No, wait up, Bruna. Oh, here he is, here, look at him. Still puffed up.
Ready to show the people.
They used to have frogs in that one, but they got this guy in here.
Who's up? Freddy's cool. Oh, that's right. Shouldn't there be bunny in the light?
No, he likes the light because they're like warm.
Okay.
Yeah. Well done. You're getting good, eh?
Yeah.
All the practice at home on our tramp, eh?
Yeah. I can run.